Hi students, I am Father Johnson. I hope you are all keeping fine and I am sure that you are preparing yourselves for the exams. Now in this present video presentation, we are going to concentrate on the new pattern of the question paper for the subject English core of class 12th. Since you are first time appearing, most of you must be unfamiliar with the pattern. So I would like to explain the whole pattern of the question paper. That is the content of this video presentation. Now, we have 100 marks of question. Out of 100 marks, we have 80 with pen paper test, 20 internal assessment in the form of ASL. Out of this 80, we have got the reading skill, writing skill and literature. Reading skill, which covers 20 marks, writing skill 16 marks and literature 44 marks. So all these three skills, reading, writing and literature, that is amounting to 80 marks. And assessment of speaking and listening, that is for 20 marks, that is internal assessment. Now I would like you to pay proper attention to what I am going to say. Now out of this 80 marks, it is divided into two sections, section A and section B. Section A, completely it is objective. The assessment, the pattern of assessment is completely objective. So you will be given four options. You have to choose the most correct one out of the first section one. And section two, it is remaining 40, it is more descriptive. So let us try to understand this. Now first, as I said, reading skill. Reading skill, the purpose of reading skill, it tries to test the competency of a child regarding how much the child is able to understand, the level of recording, analyzing, inferring, that is a logical interpretation, interpreting a particular paragraph, how you are able to appreciate literary appreciation, and how much of vocabulary you have got, how you are able to summarize, and all these skills are being tested in the reading skill, which covers 20 marks. So the question is, you will be given two questions, two paragraphs. First, you will be given a paragraph. The paragraph, after having read the paragraph, you will be given 11 questions with four options, choosing the most correct one. So in the light of what you have read in the paragraph, you are supposed to choose the most correct one of, you have to choose, answer 10 questions out of 11. So which means, question number 1, which has got 11 options, out of which you are supposed to write 10. Each question carries 1 mark. So 10 into 1, 10 marks. So similarly, you have got 2 paragraphs. So it amounts to 20 marks. So when you get the question paper, you will try to understand. Next one is, it is creative writing skill, which amounts to 16 marks. So in this writing skill, what you are being tested? The competence of a child regarding the conceptual understanding, how the child is able to apply the rule, how the child is able to analyze, your ability for reasoning, appropriateness of style and tone, using appropriate forms and format, and fluency, inference, analysis, evaluation and creativity. All these skills are being tested in the creative skill, creative writing skill. So you are supposed to use all these things, how much you are able to logically think, how much you are able to present it in the proper format, and how well you are able to present the content. All these skills are being tested in the writing skill, which is only 16 marks, unlike the previous years. In the previous years, it used to be more, but then this year, in the context of present pandemic, they have reduced the content and it amounts only for 16 marks. Now let us try to understand what are things you are being asked. Now question number 1 of the writing skill, which comes in section B. Question number 1, you will be given 2 options. One, either notice or advertisement. So you have to prepare, there will be notice or advertisement which will have to be presented in maximum 50 words. And you are supposed to write in the proper format. So try to understand, you will be given either a notice or advertisement in the question number 1 of writing skill, which has only 3 marks. The word limit is 50 mark, 50 word limit is 50, but then it has got only 3 marks, for which You will be given 1 mark for the proper format. You have to follow the correct format. You have to follow the content that you present, which carries 1 mark, and the expression, how well you are able to present it, express it. So all these three. So you will get three marks for question number one. Now question number two, you will be asked to write formal, informal invitations and replying to the invitations in 50 words. So one of the two will be answered. You have to answer one of the two, not both. One of the two will be answered. Either formal invitations or informal invitations and replying to the invitations in 50 words. Same, which has got 3 marks. So same way, format carries 1 mark, content 1 mark, and expression 1 mark. So 3 plus 3, 6. So remaining 10, out of the remaining 10, question number 3, which has got 5 marks, you will be asked to write letters to the editor, or replying to the vacancies or job applications, all these things. So which has letters based on verbal, visual input. Sometimes you will be given some visual input on the basis of which you have to write the letter. It has to be answered in approximately 120 to 150 words. What type of letters? Letter types includes application for a job. How you are able to, how you will apply yourself for a job, your candidature. Letters to the editor, giving suggestions or opinion on issues of public interest. And one of these has to be answered. Either you write within the given options, you will write one, which has got 5 marks. Out of 5 marks, you get 1 mark for the format, 2 marks for the content, and 2 marks for the expression. So try to understand. This question number 3, it has got 5 marks, 1 for the format, 1 for the content, 2 marks for the content, and 2 marks for the expression. So question number 4, again it has got 5 marks. This time they have deleted debate and speech. So you will be given an option between an article or report, article writing or report writing, for which you get 5 marks. Out of 5 marks, you will get 1 mark for the format, 2 marks again for the content, 2 marks for the expression. Again, it has to be written in maximum 120 to 150 words. Please do not exceed the word limit. Don't overwrite, don't try to exceed, don't write more than what is needed. You are wasting your time and you are going to lose your marks. Do not think that by exceeding the words, you will get more marks. No, it is a wrong presumption. So please limit yourself to the word limit that has been given and do not exceed the word limit. So we have got 16 marks. 3, 3, 5, 5. 16 marks for the writing skill. Now we come to the section 3, that is literature. Literature, we have got 2 books. Already we have covered all the 15 lessons for the current session as far as the literature is concerned, Flamingo and Vistas. You know the book. Now what they are trying to check, what they are trying to assess through this literature, the competency of a child, how the child is able to recall, how the child is able to reason, and appreciating literary convention, inference, analysis, creativity with fluency. So for which we have got 44 marks, 20 marks for the reading skill, 16 marks for writing skill, and 44 marks for literature, which amounts to 80 marks. Now try to understand. Now you know the first, let us try to understand the syllabus from the book Flamingo. From the book Flamingo, for the prose, we have got 5 lessons. The last lesson, Lost Spring, Deep Water, The Rat Trap, Indigo. The other 3 are skipped. They are not part of the syllabus for the current session. From the poetry, we have got My Mother at 66, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, Keeping Quiet, A Thing of Beauty, Aunt Jennifer's Tiger. So these are the 5 poetry from the book Flamingo. Now from the book Vistas, we have got another 5 lessons. The third level, The Enemy, Should Wizard Hit Mummy, On the Face of It, Evans Tries an O Level. So 5 prose from Flamingo and 5 poetry from Flamingo, and another 5 lessons from book Vistas. So totally we have covered almost all the 15 lessons. 10 prose and 5 poetry we have covered. So this is the syllabus as far as literature is concerned. Now, let us try to understand. The whole literature is divided into two sections. One is part, the 20 marks comes in the form of part A, and the remaining 24 marks you have to, they have to be answered in the section part B. Then part A, you will be given question number 3, part A, you will be given 3 extracts from the book Vistas and Flamingo, only prose. Only prose, not poetry. Here, you will be given 3 extracts from the book Flamingo and Vistas, out of which you have to answer 2 extracts, not 3. You have to answer 2 extracts, and each extract carries 4 questions. So, 4 questions for each extract. Out of 3, you will answer 2 extracts. So, 2 extracts, which means it covers 8 marks. 8 questions will be there, 4 from one extract, another 4 marks from extract second. So, out of the 3, 2 you have to answer, for which you will be given 8 marks. Again, it is in the form of choosing the most correct one. It is only for the prose. Now, question number 4, that comes, you will be given 2 extracts from the poetry. From all the 5 poetries, you will be given 2 extracts, for which you have to answer 1, not both. You have to answer 1, and that has got again 4 questions, and each question carries 1 mark each. So, 4 into 4 questions which carries one each mark, which means another 4 marks for the extract from the poetry. Now, the part A for the literature, we have got question number 5, in which you will be given 10 questions with the form of choosing the most correct one, for which you have to answer 8 questions, and each question carries 1 mark each. So naturally, we have got 8 plus 4 plus 8, which amounts to 20 marks for the book, for the literature in the part A. It has to be answered in the form of choosing the most correct one. It is objective, not descriptive, it is objective. Now let us come, as I said, we have got 24 marks, we have got 44 marks, out of 44 marks for the literature, 20 marks have to be answered in the part A, in the form of objective assessment. The remaining 24 of literature, it is covered in part B. So let us see how you have to answer. There will be 5 short answer type questions, out of 6 from prose and poetry from the book Flamingo. So, from the book, the question number 6 from part B, only you will be given 6 questions from the book Flamingo, and out of 6 questions you have to answer only 5 within the word limit, 30 to 40 words, not more than that. Each question carries 2 marks, so naturally you have got 10 marks. Then question number 7, you will be given 3 questions from the book Vistas. There will be 3 questions from the prose Vistas, out of which you have to answer only 2 questions, and each question carries 2 marks, which amounts to 4 marks. Now another one, now question number 8, you will be given a long answer type question from the book Flamingo. For the question number 8, from the book Flamingo, you will be given 2 questions, out of which you have to answer 1, and it has to be answered in maximum 120 to 150 words. It has 5 marks. You have to answer only 1. This is only from the book Vistas. Same way for question number 9 from the book. This is question number 8 is from book Flamingo, and question number 9 is from the book Vistas. Both the questions will have 2 each questions. Question number 8 from the book Flamingo, either from the prose or from the poetry, you will be given a question, out of which you had to answer 1. Same way for question number 9, you had to answer one of the questions from the book Vistas, which had to be answered in 120 to 150 words, and for which you get 5 marks. So we have got 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 4, 14, 14 plus 10, 24. So from the book literature, 20 from the form of objective assessment, 24 in the form of descriptive assessment. So this is how the question pattern is. And so far, in all the 15 videos, we have covered all the literature part of it. Now, the remaining 16 marks of writing skill, we are not started. In the coming days, we will present those videos of writing skill as far as the current session is concerned. So, you please try to prepare yourselves well and try to read the questions properly and try to answer. This is the pattern, this is a board pattern, and I wish that all should be familiar with the new pattern. Please do not follow the old pattern. This is a new pattern and you should familiarize yourself with the new pattern. And all the best for your exams. Hope you will do well. See you in the next video. Thank you.